गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, लेट्स कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर इवान ट्राइज एंड ओ लेवल एंड वी आर एट द पेज नंबर 79, फ्यू लाइंस ऑफ इवान। एट लास्ट इवान, प्लीज सर, अ विस्पर। इवान, प्लीज सर, लाउडर। इवान, वुड यू माइंड इफ आई पुट अ ब्लैंकेट राउंड मी शोल्डर सर, इट्स अ बिट पाकी इन हेयर, isn't it? What is the meaning of paaki? Is it disagreeable, cold or chilly? Because he was giving his exam inside a prison cell and because of that area he was feeling some kind of coldness was there. Ivan, there's one on me, bunk here sir, bunk a type of small place, very insidely, McCleary, be quick about it, it means provide him blanket quickly. Then silence. At 10:51, Stephen was more than a little surprised to see a grey regulation blanket draped round Ivan's shoulders. He frowned slightly and looked at the examinee more closely. He was very much careful. Who? Stephen. Stephen was every time watching Ivan very carefully. When Ivan covered himself with the blanket, but Ivan, the pen still between his teeth. Ivan, who was thinking something to write down his question paper, all staring just as vacantly as before and blankly beneath a blanket. Should Stephen's report the slight irregularity? Anything at all fishy? Hadn't Jackson said? He looked through peep hole once again, even as did he saw Ivan pull the dirty blanket more closely to himself. Every inch, every moment, the blanket was covering around the body of Ivan very closely. And was he planning a sudden Batman leap to suffocate McCleary in the blanket? Oh, Stephen was thinking that because they were very well understood what are the planning of Ivan and what can he do here. Might be he can use this kind of blanket to make suffocate McCleary. Don't be daft. There was never any sun on this side of the prison, no heating either during the summer months, and it could get quite chilly in some of the cells. Stephen decided to revert to his earlier every minute observation, but his own thought aversion to him that of course it was chilly inside because where the Ivan is sitting for his exam there is a place not a single rays of sun enter here, that is why it is a very cold place. At 11:20 a.m. the receiver once more crackled across the silence of the governor's office. McCleary informed Ivan that only few minutes remain, the examination was almost over now. But something still gnawed away quietly in the governor's mind, he reached for the phone once more. At 11:22 a.m. Jackson shouted along the corridor to Stephen. The governor wanted to speak with him. Hurry, man. Stephen picked up the phone apprehensively and listened to the rapidly spoken order. Stephen himself was to accompany McCleary to the main prison gates. Understood, Stephen personally was to make absolutely sure that the door was locked on Ivan after McCleary had left the cell. Understood. As the order of the governor, Stephen himself escorted McCleary from the prison room to the entrance gate where complete checking, and after that he was just taking Mr. McCleary out from the prison. And at 11, and he was very sure that after the exit of McCleary from the prison cell, the door was locked properly because there was Ivan inside the cell. At 11:25 a.m. governor heard the final exchange. McCleary, stop writing please. Silence. McCleary, put your sheets in order and see they are correctly numbered. Silence. Scrapping of chair and table. Governor was instructing Stephen and Jackson every time, every minute, and it was the time when exam was over, and he ordered Stephen that he must be escort Mr. McCleary from the prison cell to the outside door of the prison. Ivan, thank you very much, sir. McCleary, right was it, Ivan? Not too bad, McCleary, good. Mr. Stephen, the governor heard the door clang for the last time. The examination was over. How did he get on, do you think? Asked Stephen as he walked beside McCleary to the main gate. After the examination was over, Stephen, who was beside the McCleary, and they both were going to the exit point from the prison, he was asking about what kind of performance Ivan given in his exam. What do you think, Mr. McCleary? Oh, I can't think. He has distinguished himself. I am afraid his Scott accent seemed broader than ever, and his long black overcoat reaching almost to his knee fostered the illusion that he had suddenly grown slimmer. Stephen noticed some kind of strange thing there. The coat that was worn by Mr. McCleary, now it is almost to his knee, and his shoulder was looking broader than before, and there were some changes. It means Mr. McCleary was looking some slimmer comparative to before when he was entered inside there. And what is the meaning of the fostered hair? It means encourage. The physical appearance of McCleary is quite different from the appearance when he was entered inside the prison at morning. Stephen felt pleased that governor had asked him and not Jackson, but Stephen feeling very proud that because he is so responsible, that is why governor instructed him to do the same thing, to see McCleary off the premises. And all in all, morning had gone pretty well, but something stopped him from making his way directly to the canteen for a belated cup of coffee. And after the examination was over, he was feeling very relaxed because there was no any kind of mistake has been taken there. And Ivan, who was really given his exam very peacefully, and as they were expected, nothing was happened there. So he just wanted to have a cup of coffee, but before taking it, he just want to see Ivan once more inside the prison cell. It was like a program he would see on TV about a woman who could never really convince herself that she would lock the front door when she would gone to bed after she would got up 12 and 15 sometime 20 times to check the bolt. He compare himself at the psychology of a woman who is not satisfied always that either she has been closed the inside door of the home or not, and all the time again and again at night just she wake up from her bed and watch the door is locked carefully. He re-entered leaving and made his way along to Ivan's cell, opened the peephole once more. Oh no, Christ, no. There sprawled back in Ivan's chair was a man. A semi-second Stephen thought it must be Ivan, a grey regulation blanket slipping from his shoulders, the front of him closely cropped, irregularly tufted hair awash with fierce red blood, which had dripped already through the small black beard and was even now spreading horribly over the white clerical coat and down into the black clerical front. As the Stephen just watching inside the prison cell, he just surprised or shocked because the view inside the prison cell is really horrible. He just noticed that Ivan, who was there sitting on a chair giving his exam, not that same man. It was Mr. McCleary, and he was really bleeding severely. Stephen shouted wildly for Jackson, and the words appeared to penetrate the curtain of blood that veiled McCleary's ear. For the minister had and felt feebly for a handkerchief from his pocket and held it to his bleeding head. They were thinking that once again Ivan escaped from the prison cell, and who the person inside the prison, that is Mr. McCleary, who was injured very badly. It means Ivan injured McCleary, and very cleverly he escaped from the prison again. He gave a long low moan and tried to speak, but his voice trailed away. By the time Jackson had arrived and dispatched Stephen to ring the police and ambulance, the handkerchief was a sticky, squelchy and wedge of cloth. The handkerchief Mr. McCleary used to control the bleeding, but it was already full of blood. McCleary slowly raised himself, his face twisted, tightly with pain. Dinah worry about the ambulance man. I am right and get the police. I know where he is. He closed his eyes and another drip of blood splashed like a huge raindrop on the wooden floor. Mr. McCleary inside the prison, he was instructing all the police officers there that Ivan has escaped from the prison and he was bleeding really very severely. His hand felt along the table, found a German question paper and grasped it tightly in his blood stain. Get the governor, I know where Ivan. McCleary is instructing the officers that please call the governor, I know the place where Ivan has gone. Almost immediately, siren was sounding. Prison officer bark order, puzzled prisoners pushed their way along the corridors. Door was banged, bolted, and phone was ringing everywhere. Within a minute, McCleary with Jackson and Stephen supporting him on either side, his face now streaked, caked with drying blood, was greeted in the prison yard by the governor, perplexed and grim. The face of McCleary was not really recognizable because too much blood was already spread over his face, and immediately they were preparing to send him to the hospital. And also all the staff of the prison is active because it was a challenge to once again they have to catch Ivan. Yes, they are on their way. I'm right. Look here. Awkwardly, he opened the German question paper, thrust it before the governor's face. It's there. Oh, see what I mean. The governor looked down and realized Mr. McCleary was trying to tell him. A photocopy sheet had been carefully, cleverly and supervised over the last originally blank page of question paper. Mr. McCleary was instructing something. There was something inside the prison cell. It was mentioned the place name where Ivan has been escaped. So Mr. McCleary, in the condition of really badly injured, he was just helping out the governor and other prison officers how to catch Ivan again. Students, read out these passages once more, and tomorrow we will continue the further part of the chapter, that's Ivan Tries and O Level. Thank you. Goodbye.